Well, you know what? We'll do one more chapter. The AD Dimension Fleet has arrived. Is that the Nadesco? According to Captain Hoshnell, it's the successor to the Nadesco B we knew. And the pink-colored ship is the Eternal, from Plant. Their battle prowess seems to have increased over in their own dimension. Yet, but it seems all the ships took damage. They hardly seem to be in shape to help us. Head a sub to patrol the surrounding waters. We're going to have to head to Tokyo 3 as we are. We'll debrief there as we resupply. Understood. Nerf's commander, Akira, is a good man to arrange the resupplies considering the condition we're in. He has entrusted his son, Sinji, to us. He's obviously trusted us greatly. Commander, he purposely summoned us, so we can't let our guard down. Yeah, that's fair. I feel like Bright and them are like, we're gonna trust your supplies, but we're not gonna like trust you fully. Like they have the intuition to be like, I don't know about this, but yeah. Where are you heading, then? Thought I'd join the world information debriefing taking place in the hangar. Will you join me, sis? Oh, that's what this is for. So if you don't want to know about like a brief snippet about what happened in that other part of the game, you can skip it and not know, and then go and play it yourself and get the full thing. Or if you don't really care about that information, you can just hit no and just skip it completely. That's actually really fucking smart. Okay. Sure, I'll join you. It's been about a month since we've seen everyone, but don't worry, I get it. This isn't exactly a party. It's just that now, with all of us banding together, we can change things. I have to believe that. Okay. Makes sense. And what about Gain? My Gain was heavily damaged as a result of my loss to Joe the Ace. Gain is now at Senpuji Heavy Industries for repair. Are you fighting on Might Wing now? No, I'm using Drill Express, aka Mike Kaiser for now. Mike Kaiser doesn't have a Super A installed, but with its flight capability, its battle prowess matches that of Mike King, which allows me to finally defeat Joe. Also, now that Black has joined us, we've gained a new member of the Brave Express Corps. Gain's brother, huh? It's encouraging to have him. And Zambot 3 got powered up with Bale's Eyes Ion Cannon 2. Oh, Bale 1's. Diatron 3 and Zambot 3 were successful in using a combination attack. We'll show it to you next battle. Biggest surprise for me is the new Nadesco. We'll call it the Nadesco C. It allows us to utilize Ruri's cracking ability so we can take over enemy computer systems. You've changed a lot, haven't you, Akito? Have I? I think that's largely in part to my help. Those whom I've met now, I'm pleased to meet you. I'm Yakura, Akito's wife, and the battle advisor of the Nadesco C. Stop it, Yakura. You don't need to be so clingy. But we're newlyweds. We need to be making up for the lost time we were apart. This is neither time nor the place. Just look around you. My apologies. That was thoughtless of me. It's not a problem. Stand corrected. You haven't changed just a little bit, Akito, but rather quite a bit. Speaking of which, you all only know him as Akito the Avenger. The guy is cuddling with his wife here is the real Akito. It's great that you're back together again. Thank you. We're looking forward to working with you all. Akito and Yakura seem to be getting along quite well. Not unlike you and Lacus when you got together. Really. Just kidding. Well, you have to admit, you two really did show us a real strength in your bond with each other. Yakura and Chita finally learned to compromise. Yeah, you're right. Overcoming his past has helped Shin grow much stronger. He and I were dead on with our combination attacks. Being able to use Meteor outfit on the attorney has made my justice and Kira's freedom much stronger. Our Gundams have been upgraded as well. The Zambia and the Tari were upgraded with parts, and my Raphael and Quantum both received power output upgrades. Hold on just a second, Tyria. Don't forget about Grams and my machines. Mobile suits have significantly stronger now with the Trans Am. But just the power of that alone, there isn't anyone who cannot defeat. Embryo, the evil mastermind in the AD dimension. Celestial Being must avenge his monstrous distortion of the world. So Soji left Tatsu's home, huh? Yeah. It hasn't contacted anyone since. That sounds like Soji, careless as always. Are you worried about him? Of course. Soji may act like he does, but in fact, he's a pretty shrewd character. I'm sure he's doing well, and I expect he'll show up when the fighting's over. Sure. Alright, first, would you please introduce yourselves? I am a descendant of Aura and princess of Freya. Freya, however you want to say it. Vice Admiral of the Imperial Guard. Salamandini? In your language, a dragon, a person of this world. A dragon. So the legends are true. You did exist in our world. The red pseudo-paramail that we fought countless times is Sailor's. It's called the Inryugo. Inryugo? Please stop using the word paramail. It's so inelegant. But your machine names are too difficult to remember. Well, it seems like these two have become friends. We have erected a barrier and isolated ourselves, choosing to live as such for several thousand years. Several thousand? Correct. Is this planet civilizations were all destroyed? Destroyed? It's been speculated that there were once ancient civilizations, but it was never deemed demonstrated. We've been unknowingly living alongside dragons this whole time? It's only natural you didn't know. It's impossible to infiltrate the barrier, and we ourselves employ an invisible barrier to hide ourselves when we venture out. In other words, advanced stealth capabilities. You call yourself dragons, but you look completely human to me. I'll let this young lady explain. Question time. What am I? You are Vivian, no? Correct, but I'm also a dragon. What? Excuse me? Might be difficult to swallow, but it's true. Vivian is a dragon. She's indeed of the dragon clan. She lost her memory in an accident and such. She ended up living in your AD dimension. Moreover, women of our kind can change form at will. Of the dragons we fought, smaller forms were women and the larger ones were men. Dragons can change into humans? How did you obtain this ability? Ongo, like you, we were unable to change. Our transformation came thousands of years ago during a war with man versus man and man versus evil. The world was polluted by the war, and humanity was on the brink of extinction. Dragonium? Dragonium in the distant past. It purified the special cosmos rays and the crystallized supersymmetric particles. What? Exactly. We're supposed to bring the world to an enlightened age. War broke out soon after its discovery instead. It was used against the enemies of humanity, but in the final battle of the war, the Dragonium went out of control and destroyed the world. And surviving humans abandoned the Earth and traveled in search of a new land. On our parallel Earth, those were my ancestors. Who are you? My name is Tusk. I'm the last of the ancient people. The ancient people? According to Commander Jill of Arsenal, the humans who escaped the pollution of the Universal Century Dimension came to Aiden Dimension about 500 years ago. After forcibly entering that dimension, they tried to create an ideal society of race of humans. The founding nations, humans who could use mana. After reaching the Aiden Dimension, their very existence was denied. They became the ancient people. ideal world, you'd call a world where those who were born unable to use mana and thus discriminated against ideal? The Noma's bursts were a miscalculation, but he used discrimination towards them to maintain the status quo. Furthermore, using them to intercept dragons. Who is he? A man named Embryo. A man who entered the Aether Dimension, created the Founding Nations, and through that power has controlled the world from the shadows. Controlled the world? Jill has described Embryo as a god. In the history of the Aether Dimension, he was described as a war against Embryo. As a countermeasure against mana users, the ancient people used birth, gave birth to children with modified genes, of which the coordinators are just one type. My name is Lacus Klein. I'm with Plant. The secret of coordinator's birth was told me by my father. Also, Celestial Bean's founder, Aliyah Schausenberg, is related to the ancient people. Whoever wrote this story clearly delve deep enough into all these shows to, like, tie together so many threads from all these shows to make a somewhat comprehensible story. And that takes, like, craft. God damn. It is believed that Celestial Bean was in part organized to chase down and overthrow Embryo. Embryo was also the man behind the development of the Regna Males, the ultimate weapon used to destroy the world in the past. The Black Paramales that appeared on Mars during the final battle was also a Regna Male. The ultimate weapon that destroyed the world, that is the kind of power Embryo wields? Embryo enjoys control of the Aether Dimension. He does it for pleasure and out of his own interest. This is what makes him a monster. The many wars in our world are his doing. The ancient people joined with Norma to overthrow Embryo's tyranny. And several decades ago, we were able to steal one of his regna males, Angie's Vilcus. In order to bring out the machine's true power, certain criteria have to have met, and Angie meets them. In fact, Commander Jill has been forging Jill into a weapon of her counter offense, Libertuis. Wait, what? I assume that means it means to say aging. Quite obvious that Embryo's character is evil, as all get out. So you dragons are out for revenge against the man who destroyed your world, but invading the aging dimension? But you answer that, I want to know why the people of this world have the ability to change into dragons. Both those questions are related to our god ancestor Aura. In order to live in the polluted world, my ancestor made a profound decision. By utilizing the power of the Dragonium, we remade our bodies so as to adapt to the environment. Remade. Correct. That was the birth of Aura. Our god ancestor Aura, the great founder who reshaped the flesh of her own body to live in that polluted environment. In the words of your people, the first dragon. Dragons are humans who remade themselves? My ancestor took responsibility for their sins and decided to live a life of atonement, purification, side by side with Aura. The men transmogrified into gigantic dragons, their bodies dedicated to purification of the world. Incredible. Taking the Dragonium that polluted the earth into their bodies, they changed it into stabilized crystals. Huh. That's kind of neat. There are many times when women change and work with the men, and times when they birth and raise children. In an effort to never make the same mistake again, our ancestors decided to put ways with the industrialization and limit ourselves to living in harmony with nature. This dragon named Aura is leader of yours, ordering you to invade the 80 dimension? That's incorrect, I'm afraid. Our god ancestor Aura is currently in Angie's world. I'm not sure I follow. She was taken there against her will. In the distant past, Dragonium was discovered, Regna Male was produced, the world was destroyed and abandoned, and behind it, all was Embryo. Begin with this Embryo guy. You know where that power that this world calls man is derived from? You can't be saying that what I think you are. Light of Mana, Utopia, the world of magic, underpinned all of its energy from the Aura's Dragonium. but someday it'll be exhausted and will need to be replenished. Dragons are killed, the crystallized dragon omen extracted and is given to Aura to recharge her. I see. That's the truth of what normals are, being put in their lives, putting their lives in line for. During our fight, we have learned that Aura is being held in Angie's ancestral homeland, the Misurugi Empire. I no longer send that country my home, Angie. According to Setsuna, Angie is not only despised by her brother and sister, but they planned a public execution of her. She's right, she no longer has a home or a family. Well, then let's get right to defeating Embryo and feeding Aura. What are we waiting for? With the war in the 80 dimension finished, you can help us, and then we can become friends with the dragon people. Must not underestimate Embryo. Tusk is correct. The Ragnamail in his possession has this unimaginable strength. He destroyed Arsenal in a battle in which Sayla, Eshra, and Chris all went missing. Sayla. Ragnamails are machines with the power to destroy the world, huh? But can he really destroy the world with just a couple of machines like that? That's the power of their dimensional resonating weapons. I hope to replicate that power with a space-time convergence cannon on my Embryo. In Ryugo, the Ragnamails have the power to destroy space-time as well. Destroy space-time? Are you serious? It's the power of Dragonium. This is the equivalent of like someone going unobtainium, in a sense. The power that can create mana and destroy space-time is both fearsome and horrible. It's the same power we use, though. Yoma? It's all clear now. Dragonomen and Gitter Rage are one and the same. Correct. What? Dragons exist to purify Dragonium, and that ability allows them to suppress Gitter Rays. Sounds like you know a lot about the existence of dragons already, Dr. Satomi. Wow, organisms that actually absorb Gitter Rays. Well, then I guess it's no wonder you dubbed the new Gitter Shindragon. What you're saying is that the residual Gitter Ray pollution from 15 years ago? Dissipated faster than expected because of dragons? Under the direction of our leader, the High Priestess, our friends and fellows have been dispatched to aid in the purification. So our world was saved by dragons. Afraid of making the same mistake as our ancestors, we cut off contact with the outside world. But we do not wish for the destruction of the world. The planet is the very dear to us. If you truly believe that, then I am positive we can be friends and allies, like Angie and the other Normas. In our ignorance of the situation, we were your enemies. It is most unfortunate. But now that we know the truth, how can we come to a compromise? Until just a little while ago, I would have flatly rejected your offer. However, now in light of how narrow-minded I have been, I am delighted to accept your offer. Sailor. And you're the one who changed my mind. Also, I will gladly fight side by side with you. Me too, Angie. But I will no longer fight by your side as a Knight of Vilcus, rather a Knight of Angie. Thank you, Tusk. Angie is Embryo's target, and so it falls on us to protect her. Because he wants to recover the stolen Ragnamail? It's more essential than that. In a sense, he wants to obtain Angie herself. Stop it. Weird thought of that, the way he looks at me is giving me the creeps. But now you are here in this world. There is no way he can track you here. You would be mistaken. You've forgotten, Koji? Embryo is originally from this world. He can manipulate time and space with the power of Dragonium. He was even able to infiltrate our dragon barrier. Princess Salamandry, you have an emergency. What is it? High Priestess says something is here to destroy order. What? Destroy order. Incoming communication from Nerve HQ. There's an angel on approach to Tokyo 3. What? Did Commander Akira anticipate this solution when he called us in to help? There's something here to destroy order, as Dragonclan says. Could it be an angel? That's not it at all. That's not at all it seems it can do. Those who disturb peace and harmony should be considered enemies of the world, and thus we should work towards a common goal of defeating them. All I need to know is where to shoot everyone into your machines. And you wait. It'll be some time before the angel arrives. We should intercept it before it gets here. It won't be possible. The eighth angel is descending from space. We're in a spaceship. Just go up into space. What? Just go up into space. All right. Take flight, brave heroes. We're in a spaceship. Just go up into space, dog. Like, come on. Let's see. We'll take out Bright. I would have never thought it possible for an angel to approach from outer space. The AT field is distorting the light. It's frightening, and I suppose it's tempted to land here, correct? Maggie, recalculation is just in. There is almost 100% probability it's headed for Nerve HQ. I don't even know how to reply to that. How has Neo Zeon reacted? They are adapting a wait-and-see stance. They're just going to sit back and watch as humanity is wiped from the face of Earth without even lifting a finger. Seem like we can modify the angel's trajectory? We ran the calculation numerous times. It's impossible. It's concentrating on maintaining its AT field, the energy of which will be added to that of the impact. So nothing sort of an all-out attack will work against it. The angel itself is a bomb, huh? Estimated direct hit, blast rate scale of a diameter of 420,000. That will leave a negative 15,000 geodepth depression. I assume that just means a big asshole. I'm not a science person. I assume that just means a big asshole. Kirk 3 will be evaporated and leave both geofront and central dogma completely exposed. Naturally, we are not going to let that happen. That means you wanted to stop the angel, correct? Is that even possible? Only an evil with the same AT field can stop it. Even then, the chance of success is a mere 0.1%. Don't be kidding. 12 feet, daddy's boy? Did you just hear what she said? If you're afraid, you and the commander's pet can go hide while I stop the angel with the O2. Relax, Secure. Yamato has been standing by for just a situation. The infrastructure has been confirmed. We can add the Yamato's firepower to the attack. It might not destroy the AT field, but it will most definitely slow the angel's rate of descent. My experience indicates that this will raise chances of success to 50%. Just 50%, huh? Hey, that's 1,000 times 1%. Thanks, Yumi. That's actually reassuring. Nice to see Daddy's boy and Commander's pet are still getting along so well. That's enough. Chikinami, I don't care what you call, but stop calling Ayumi that. But it's the truth. No, there's no lack of tension among them, is there? Suppose it beats being called by the pressure. We may not have the choice but to use the wave motion gun this time. The motion gun, sir? We know nothing of what the enemy is capable of. Proceed with preparations. Yes, sir. Command. Captain. We still have time until Ranger arrives, so keep your cool yet, Harry. Not what got me worried. Our instruments are just registered a singular reaction. What? Are you saying this? It's not a dragon teleportation? The dimensional door is opening. Oh, that's going to be a lot. The DG Alliance. What are the DG, what are the AD Dimension Villains doing here? Without a jumper to navigate it, life form cannot take corporeal shape after a jump. We have to use some other means that a parallel boss jump to teleport. What's going on? 1 minute Mr. X has instructed us to attack a detachment of troops, and next we're caught up in some kind of magnetic storm. You have a problem with my method of transportation? It can't be. Embryo. Long time no see, Angie. That's the AD mentioned Shadow Ruler. I told you, I really don't like that term. I prefer Lunar. Listen up, dear AG associates. This is the day's battlefield. Wreak havoc to your heart's content. You mean you're our sponsor, Mr. X? That is the question, isn't it? He's gone. This is Tux said. The Emerald Guy can manipulate space-time as he pleases. Well, I guess quiet any doubters, he just broke through the dimensional barrier by any means other than Oh, a Boston jump. What should we do now, Wolfgang? Our own world just warped around us. You're asking me? This really puts us at a pinch. But I say we withdraw. They're attacking. That's Joe piloting that black robot. Joe, wait. We're in the middle of a very important operation now. If we fail, this world might as well be destroyed. What? What do you mean destroyed? So what? What of it? Joe, my singular purpose in life is to defeat you, Maltos and Bougie. And as this isn't even my world, I don't care what happens to it. A one-track mind, I swear. If we refuse to fight, the embryo character will surely leave us here. And you won't be able to return to our world? More than that, we might even simply cease to exist, the kind of power he has. We have no choice but to fight. You fools, don't take a look around. Don't you see what's happening? Seriously? I don't understand the mind of villains. We have no choice either. All units launch. Man, these guys are assholes. Like, all the time. Well, since we don't have to worry about, like, people anymore, we can just boop, 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 boop. Come on, right? And we do have the boys are back in town now, so... Let's get Sosuke up there. Up her. What's she at? 32? Ready then. And then we'll pop. Let's get the Freeman Justice going. Yeah. And then, Amazing UC. So you've come out from hiding after all, Matope Simpuji. Joe, I never thought you'd stoop as low as you have right now. Say what you like, your defeat is my sole purpose in life. That's why I accepted this Guryu from Mr. X. Joe, show us how brilliant you can defeat him with my true masterpiece, the Guryu. Guryu. You sure took your sweet time in constructing it. I had no choice. Our sponsor mistakes told me to remove the drill nose. I had created for it. Joe's perfect for it. It really irks me when people complain about the aesthetics of my robots. I won't come out on your personal tastes, but I have to admit this machine is by far your best yet. Bigger question than who are you? Without a doubt, it will be more powerful as well. Look lively, gang. Guryu is going to be a mighty foe. No matter what. No matter, you won't defeat me, Joe. I'll win for this world, for gain, and for justice. I can't take Malto seriously half the time because they do that at the end. They go like, for justice. And every time I hear justice, I just think the Overwatch thing and the weird voice all the time. Can't do it. Every time. I really... Still using that word? Masato. What should we do? Fight, what else? If they interfere, the whole operation goes to hell. Dragon Clan will work to slow the Angel's descent. Even then, I estimate the Angel will hit 2-3 in 3 minutes. At least 5 minutes to take care of these creeps. Let's do it. Prepare yourself, Shinji. Alright. Toji, Tsuki, and all the others watching. I can't run from my duty. I have to be strong. Heard them, folks. You have 5 minutes to take care of the DG Alliance while we prepare for the arrival of the Angel. Going for you, Joe. I don't care what world we're in. I'll defend it. Mato Senpuji, you turned my stomach. Hero's job is never done. Anyway, let's move. We'll move Kira and Atherin down here so they can, like, team up and start beating the shit out of them and hold off. Hey. 900? Okay. I believe these guys are upgraded. I also don't understand why the Ignition song is so loud. Like, it's one of the few songs that's, like, oddly amped up for some reason. I don't know. It's weird. Move Sosuke down here. Or, no, Koji down here. Will Beast Fire. Sorry, Breast Fire. I really thought it was Beast Fire for so long. But I guess when you're taking the attack, literally, it really is just all right. It really is just Gatling guns in the... Oh, wow, okay. It is just Gatling guns. Doesn't matter how I do it, does it? Let's see. 43. Okay, we'll move her down. Move you up. Move you up. Move you up. Move you down. You down. Move you over. You over? Oh shit! All right. Well, fuck. Did this guy in particular clearly? New Gundam de shitomete miseru. And bye. We'll move you up. You up here. You down. Fuck you hitting. Oh. Eh. That can go to those guys down there. Station Particle Converted Cannon Sire. That's a name. That's a fucking name right there. Oh, wow. I don't think I've seen this. Demolition gun will use. Raja, shojun wa omakase kudasai. Yoshi. Ima da! Fukitobe! Mifune sama aru kagiri. Well, I'm pretty sure that's not a nuke, but damn is it close. Look at me, Daddy's boy and Commander's pet. Look. You gotta be pilots through connections. I'll show you what real talent it takes to be an evil pilot. Huh? Asuka, I think it's dead. Like, I think you have done enough damage to it to impale it multiple times. God damn. Zero. Perfect. I may or may not have forgotten to put skills into her. Which is fine. Well, if the pretty sure the Finn funnels are gonna kill him. So I don't think the support's kinda needed. Ten enemy craft shot down. That's a good pace. We just win after all. A real tremor begins after we destroy this enemy. True. Not really 10. Alright. I guess. No, it's 6, huh? I actually really like the design of the Leviathan. It's very neat. It's also very busy. Again, we're killing people with power rainbows. The best kind of rainbow. The violent ones. I was watching this battle. Strange though, unlike the first time I ever piloted an Viva, I'm not worried about what Father thinks. Right then. Time to really throw myself in the fight, and I'm gonna do it no one other than myself. Jinji, you just stabbed someone in the deck. I have so many concerns. Okay. Just a bean. We've seen that enough. We've seen that enough. And that one, we've seen enough. Like, a lot. I think he was dead after the Iron Cutter got through it, but, you know, just to, you know, make absolutely sure it's dead, let's just, you know, full on just unload hell. Seems pretty good. Axed by volume. All right, nice, nice. How do you do it? I question the design of the Strike Freedom in some capability, because it's like, here's this like giant cannon, right? Like it's in the belly near the cockpit, and it's like, is this how new types happen? You radiated them? It's actually kind of what I wanted, because now they're like, they're all converging onto other people, and I don't really have to do anything. I just have to move the unit down there, so it's actually pretty good. Fuck this one guy in particular. Fuck that guy. And fuck that guy too, apparently. Joe's probably gonna jump down onto Malta. More than likely. Yeah. We'll do... Wishing so he doesn't do the thing, and then come on, Matos and Puji. Come avenge your beloved might Gain. Gain doesn't need avenging, it holds no appeal to him. Brave Express Corps fight for justice above all. You really are clueless. Justice is meaningless. And after I beat you to a bloody pulp today, you'll be forced to admit it. Gilbert is much stronger. As much stronger machine than Horiyo. Not so much I can't win. As much I can win.
Maito Kaiza, Hisatsu Dorino Kogik! Ukete miro! Dorino Crusher! Sochak Kanryo!
Oh, damn!
Doda Senpuji Maito!
That Gorilla Volt is strong. Speed, power, and mobility. All of them are better than Mike Kaiser's own. Even more frightening is how perfectly Joe is able to fight with it. What's the matter, Mato? Is that fear, desperation, and impatience I hear in your voice? Joe, I'm begging you, give up this fight. Recklessness used to be your only redeeming quality, and now you have cool feet? This is not the time. I'm not at leisure to fight you right now. Don't you get it, Joe? There are billions of people in this dimension. I have to protect them. I don't want to hear it, Mato. I'm going to beat you, and that's all there is to my life. If you're going to stop me, then go to your grave quietly. Never! Ha! I'll never allow myself to succumb to evil, because of your vaunting justice. That's not at all. Not it at all. I won't, because I'm human. Human! Wake up, Joe. What are you trying to do? Trying to do once you've done it can't be undone. Don't throw away your humanity, Joe. Shut up, it's too late. You're despicable, Joe. Tetsuya, you're not here for Koji at a time like this, are you? No, not right now. Huh? Mazinger's mission is to protect the world. Joe the Ace, forget Mato, I'm the one you want to fight. Oh, how interesting. Well, then, I guess I'll start with you. No, Joe, fight me. Wait, Mato. I won't lose. I swear to Gain, I'll never lose again. You want to need more than just enthusiasm to win. Yeah? We'll see about that. Huh? Sorry to keep you waiting, boss. Tunnel's now open and the rails are connected. Massive increase in Boston particle reaction is a parallel of Ocean Jump. Reinforces from the AD dimension? Without a Class A jumper to navigate it, a jump would be unbearably painful. You're not thinking straight, kiddo. Humans aren't the only life forms out there. Sorry to keep you waiting, Mato. No worries, you arrived just as scheduled, Gain. Gain, is that you? That's right, Black, back on the front line and in the thick of the fight. Gain! Welcome back, Gain. Welcome your return. Oh, I see. As we have a machine body, a bench jump is no problem. But when did you pray to make the transfer? You see, the Brave Express Corps doesn't need to make robots and jumps. I came up with the idea myself. and with the corporation of Shimpuji Concern, they created the Brave Express Coach Transfer System. We call it the Parallel Boston Jump Railway. That's too long. No kidding. Thank you for your work. Pleasure was nothing. Right now, only the Universal Century and 80 are connected, but eventually we want to connect a multitude of parallel worlds. Just to hear that the Super Space Communications, the device developed by Yamato, distance has been used. And thanks to you, Sana, we've been able to bypass dimensional barriers to establish communications. That's enabled us to create the system. Wow, that's amazing. New correct century dimension technology allowed the UC and 80 dimension to create a railway system. Gang, let's get this party started. We need you right now. Roger, Nato. Sure, I'll fight the two of you. That's where you're wrong, Joe. We're not going to fight as two, but as one! What? They formed together.
その通り。銀の翼に望みを乗せて、この星平和の青信号、勇者特急マイトガイン、英国通りにただいま到着。
So they were able to combine as Great Might Gain. Here comes a storm hero. Ooh, are you serious? It's like something out of a stupid hero comic or anime. That's what's so cool about it. Great Might Gain is the bravest of all robots. Bummer. Looks like I'm not getting into this one. Great Mazer just took off. He's headed towards the angel, probably just trying to stop it. That was fool. You don't need to be so worried about Malta. Great Might Gain. That's right, Joe. This is the world's mightiest robot. Great Might Gain. Well then, it seems there's finally an opportunity worthy of my guru. Let's finish this, Mato Senpuji. Are you ready, gang? As ever, Mato. Fantastic! Power of Great Might Gain shall forever be used in conquering evil and protecting peace. This is it, Joe. We're going to put a stop to both your robot and your twisted thinking. So anyway, I shoot this guy in the back. After I move back and forth. Will intuition? And better. Ah, Great Might Gain is a perfect match for me. Joe, there's no way you can defeat me. Get real. You fought for pretty satisfaction. I fight for those who can't fight for themselves. No way you'll defeat me. Begin with this trip. Hear me, Joe. Great Mike and I carry the burden of peace, hope, and love of a great many others in this battle. There's no way we can lose. Not as long as I hold the pride of my justice in my heart. Thought the blade would have gotten a little better, but it's not. See, that's a realistic rocket punch right there. You guys are incredible. Despite the Dragon Prince's reservations concerning Gitter Rays, you still pilot the Gitter robots. That's a scientist in me. If I don't experience Gitter Rays for myself, how can I come to a complete understanding of them? It might be that we are more akin to these dragons than the Gitter robots are. And you are ready for anything. There's nothing left for me to say. Let's do it. V3 ended Skinner with the Gitter Robots. The team, the dream team. You're in your top form today. Piece of cake. Something to say to me, Dragon Princess? No. Just intrigued by your combat maneuvers. Dragoon, no. Chosen warrior of the Gitter Riders. As one of the Dragon Clan, I'll watch your fate closely. Wait a minute. It's NTD. Will Beam Saber this one? And then this one. Bring them both down. We'll fin funnel this. Yeah, no, actually, we'll fin funnel this guy. Because that guy's almost dead. So kill that guy. Gatling gun this guy, I guess. Just bisect him down the middle. Pallet rifle this dude with the help of Asuka, which should kill it. You're steadily changing, Akira. What will become of me? Nice. Cool. Weapon volley this dude, which will kill him, which is good. That gets kills on Asuka. Or Asuka. Not Asuka. We'll shank this guy.
Hazu-san.
With the good old knee knives. That is a weird placement to place the swords. It's just in the knees. But given everything else that's on that suit, I'm not surprised in any way, shape, or form. I hit you with a big bang. We'll smash. Just to kill them quicker. That poor penguin. That poor penguin. It deserved better. Ish. Now I'm appalled. Audrey, we're retreating. No way am I going to lose this snobby after finally getting it. But we don't even know where we are. You sure you want to retreat? We'll worry about that later. Just get out of here. When you stop to think about it, they were brought here against their will. It's not even their dimension, so let them go. It makes no difference. You just let a... I mean, yes and no, but like you just let like a... like... evil robot go rampant in another world. Alright. Fair enough. We shall combine attack this one mook. He shall know the fury of the combination attack. Whether or not he deserved it, I don't know, but it looks cool. This poor Mook is just getting the absolute shit kicked out of him. This poor guy. That poor guy. Let's see. Well, we use Angie then. Discord feathers, ability unlock. I actually don't know what this does. Fuck it. See what it does. I slightly feel bad for the enemy sometimes, but like at other times it's like, oh, well, this is it sucks for you, dog. Also kind of feel bad for the surrounding town because, like, we're just blowing buildings up and everything, and they're like, no one's batting an eye. It's fine. Well, damn. It's fine. They'll come to me.
Noromame.
Oh, damn. We just blew a hole in this guy's sternum. Jesus. I kind of feel bad for that robot. It used to have a dick. It don't have one now. God damn. Okay, she's that one. We've seen that one 100 times so far. We threw a boomerang at him. I don't feel as bad. You died to a boomerang.
Oh,
I believe he was dead once the missiles impacted him at close range, but you know, we're just not sure. We'll intuition again so we don't get hit. This spirit, unfortunate. Gonna do this again, but we'll. Oh, shit, I can't smash. Unfortunate. I can't. Intuition. Joe, you lose. Can't even win with this Guryu. In our previous battle, I allowed your feelings of vindictiveness to affect me, giving rise to my doubts, and that's why I lost. Things are different now. Now I believe in myself, my friends, and justice. No way I'm going to lose to you now. Not when you are cloaked in your own doubts. Damn. Great job, Malto. It was all great Mike Gaines doing. Why did Joe hesitate? He came to me while we were fighting. Fighting in the face of the world of destruction, he was just Joe growing irritated with himself. He acts and talks like a villain, but in reality, he's just a big old softy, huh? He hasn't changed at all. If it's a fight you want, Joe, you'll get it. No matter how many times you do, I'll never lose to you a second time. Okay. So, this guy over here exists. I want him to stop existing. So, we're gonna throw the sun at him. Let's see. And, we threw the sun at him. I was hoping to just beam Magnum, but this is fine. There you go. I can't believe it. My Stark 4126 lost. Itch looks like the white collar guy that she said at his desk, like, I hate my job, but I can't tell the boss no. We need to retreat, Master Wolfgang. If our machines are destroyed, so does the next guy. I feel so bad for the henchman now. If our machines are destroyed, we'll be able to escape. We have to get to all possibilities and we can get away from it as fast as we can. You say that, but where is there we go? I will take you to safety. But you, I will explain once we see each other. I have a favor to ask of you, Miss Master Wolfgang. Alright, first we need to get to safety, no matter what. My gaining friends, I don't know if I have the right to say this, but save this world. What a selfish bunch. They're the ones who attacked first. I hear you. I thought the great evil lurking in the shadow behind them was Embryo, but now I'm not so sure. Mr. X, he's the key to everything. From the destruction of the DG Alliance forces. Captain Kitsuragi, it's your show now. Status report. Attack on Dragons and Great Messenger has succeeded in slowing the Angel's progress. However, because we were busy intercepting the enemy, we're out of time. The only thing we can do to save us now is a miracle. I guess that means it's our time to step in. Prepare to fire the wave motion gun. Yes, sir. Fire the wave motion gun. Report from Engineering. Officer Tokugawa. Intruders found in the engine. Engineering. Perform security. As suspected, a wave motion engine. Interesting. So the ship is somehow connected to... Don't move. Completely surrounded. Give up quietly. Too late. Mission to shoot granted. Mission is already complete. What's this? She was the android. What's the situation? Sorry, Apostle. We can't increase the power of the wave motion engine. Did the android do something to it? Yeah, it's impossible. I need time to investigate the cause. Damn it. Of all the rotten timing. Yeah, that dude looks grizzled. He's seen some shit. If we cannot increase the output, we will not be able to use either the wave motion cannon or the shock cannons. Apologies, Captain Kizaragi. I'm afraid you'll have to rely on the Evas. Understood. Commander Otaka. All Evas to your position. Everyone else follow. A success probability of 0.01%. You don't have a choice. Game. Let's do it, Mato. Mato, move out of the way. There are things human heroes can't do. Ubertak. It's almost there. Just another minute. Something's coming. What is that? A new Brave Express Corp team member? The Quick Draw of Justice. Okay. Might Gunner, join us. You got it. I'll assist in any way possible. Great might game. I thought, well, what are you planning? We're going to snipe the angel with great might game. The rest will be up to you. So that is what Might Gunner is for then? The target's an angel, and no average weapon is going to stop it. Game, Might Gunner, let's do it. Great Mato, we'll exceed more energy than I thought. Game, time has come to risk our lives. Alright then. Wait, what are you doing? He's going to redline the engine to compromise for lack of power. Don't do it, you're putting your life in danger. If we're not careful, you might cause a massive explosion. Great Might Gain. If we don't, we don't have a choice. We must protect this world, even if it means we die in the process. I won't let you do that. Joe, he's a jerk. He's still interfering with Mato. No, wait, look. Connect to my machine. Take the power you need from Guru. Joe. Don't get me wrong, you're not getting off that easy. I'm going to be the one to defeat you. Well, I can accept that. The Eighth Angel has reached Tokyo 3. I can't believe it. Can't be. Might Gain. This is it. Mato.
いろちがけのバトルだ。負けるわけにはいかない。ガイ、ガンナ、パーフェクトキャノンだ。了解。ベッケン、パーフェクトキャノン。グレートマイトガイ、パーフェクトモード。ターゲットスコープ、オープン。
I like how Might Gain is just like a Power Rangers show that over time, like, you know, it starts out with like five people, right? And then you get halfway through the show, here's the sixth person, here's the seventh person, and now they're just kind of combining. Right? Angel rate of ascent, decreasing rapidly. Now's our chance. Shin, Red, Asuka. Remember your breathing techniques and synchronize. Roger. Amy. Saka, this is it. Attack!
Moi-chan!
Nice. I believe that's the scene from the second movie of Eva, I believe. The other reboot? Shinji Umemoto. We did it. It's all thanks to you, Umemoto. Super Shinji, playing the hero doesn't suit you at all. That's where you're wrong, Asuka. Anyone who stands up and fight is a hero. I'm not talking about stupid smiles and catchphrases. Come on, Super Shinji, stay here and you'll be talking like this schmuck. What's the matter with you now? Did you call me Daddy's boy? Payback for calling me by my first name on the battlefield. That's not very Japanese at all. Calling him stupid isn't a bit out of line? Shut up. Shut up. Come on, Stupid Shinji. Alright, Asuka. Catch you later, Mato. Those two make a strange pair. Mato, welcome back, Gain. Fight alongside you once more made me feel alive again. Me too. Let's go. The bombers and divers are all waiting for you. Roger. Show love without saying anything. No doubt we'll meet him on the field again. Our battle grows more difficult, our enemies stronger. But we must not lose. We must join forces with our allies and protect our world. So let's point out how every single one of his robots takes up space in the ship. Like, they have to go somewhere, right? Princess Salamandi. There's no need to worry, you two. These three are the only people who can pilot the Gitter Rays. No need to worry. They won't allow the Gitter Rays to affect them. As you wish. Naga and I understand and accept your judgment in this situation, Princess. You are true, but it seems Naga has something to say. Yes, actually. Those three Gitter pilots came together in heart and mind to fight as one. In order to eliminate... Eliminate their strength. I think we should learn to combine our Rishin Kai as well. Emulate, not eliminate. Well, I'm not sure we need to go that far. If you'd like, I can provide you with the Gitter Reboa operational data. Though... What'd you say, Princess? It's quite possible I'll work with you as a leader. We could cover speed and power. These two actually seem to have adapted to the outside world quickly. A bit. On time, gang. Hope I didn't worry you, Al, so that's your new body. Overcoming defeat has made us both much stronger. You have to use that power of justice. That's right, Black. By the way, where's Nine? It's apparently very busy lately. Darn, I wanted to meet the new Brave Expert Scorp Idol. Don't complain, Mike Gunner. Nine is currently investigating the reduced Yamato's output power. That said, she did give us a message addressed to Gain. Said, welcome back, Gain. I see. Not a terribly exciting message. I disagree, besides. I'll be able to see her again soon. Quite honestly, as it would be very hard to replace her, I'm quite comfortable supporting her in any way I can. I concur. I think of her as her little sister. Right then, why don't we take her place at the factory reception to help out? I don't think that's going to work out because she's like 4'5" or something. You guys are like 20 meters tall. Oh, the perfect place for us to use my tongue twisters. And back to continue the fight, Nine. So you do what you need to do.